Citizens are confident beings. This human being is so caught up in the monetary system that it is parallel to reality, with himself, with internal organs, senses, with the universe. This human being observes through definition instead of defining through observation. It is opposite to science. Just think about this. We are on a huge sphere. Sphere because that's how we defined this form, and we see this form like that because the visual sense doesn't help us to see more than that. For instance, the magnetic field of the Earth. So, we're standing on this giant sphere, among other such forms, in a formation called the Solar System, in an extraordinarily big galaxy. One galaxy among billions of galaxies, all in a vast darkness. How can you be so confident in this situation? More than likely, you don't realize. A father will always be confident about his parent and teacher status. He will give advice, although he has no idea about psychology or how behavior is developed. He will be a mirror of the culture, and he will teach his son to fish, to pick up girls, play sport, to do what the father likes or what is found in the culture they belong to, and teaches the son because he's confident about his father status. A faithful man is extremely confident that God exists. A mother is confident that her daughter is the smartest girl in the world, that she's the best cook, or that she is a very good mother. A student who learns very well at school is confident in the educational system and even is proud of his grades. A businessman is confident about his business and economy. An actor is sure that he creates art. Art is a word with personal meaning, but considered universal. But the believer does not ask if the story is real. The mother doesn't ask what intelligence is, from whose point of view, what taste is, or what she understands about being a mother. The student doesn't ask what is the purpose of the educational system. A businessman does not ask what money is, who invented it, and what the monetary system is. An actor doesn't ask what he is actually doing, and those who appreciate art don't ask what art really means or which point of view is better. Art is art. Does it matter when it was done? How and by whom? What really matters in art? Most people on the planet Earth only scratch the surface of a subject. Once you ask yourself and investigate, you'll be shocked by what reality will reveal, but it will make sense. All these monetary system citizens live, unfortunately, in a blind faith. Actually, to believe in something, to have faith, is like betting on an unchecked idea and guide your life by it. It's the riskiest thing you can do. The monetary system created these jobs, these fixed characters, and people jump in to fit one and behave like the character's description. For instance, even those who oppose the monetary system are rushing to fit into organizations, groups, activists, militants, rockers, rappers. This kind of confidence, that is actually a lack of information, stops a possible change of the system, a change of self, an upgrading. The system maintains the current state. What if the actual state is harmful to you? How will you change it? With those kind of people, so confident on their ideas, which aren't actually theirs, it's almost impossible to discuss an idea that comes into contradiction with theirs. Besides, if you have noticed, nobody knows how to say, "I do not know." Everyone has an opinion about everything, and this led to many personal ideas taken as being true, conspiracies, religions, etc.
It's a widespread view in a democratic society that a responsible citizen ought to have an opinion about everything. Well, you can't know very much about everything, and so your opinions are likely to be based upon bullshit.
So the best thing to say is, "I don't know enough about it to give you an answer. I can't make a decision in that area. I don't have information on rockets, or how man might survive on a distant planet, it's not my field. I don't know. That's the most difficult thing for people to say. I don't know.
I can live with doubt and uncertainty and not knowing. I think it's much more interesting to live not knowing than to have answers which might be wrong. I have approximate answers and possible beliefs and different degrees of certainty about different things, but I'm not absolutely sure of anything, and there are many things I don't know anything about. But I don't have to know an answer. I don't feel frightened by not knowing things, by being lost in a mysterious universe without having any purpose, which is the way it really is, as far as I can tell, possible. It doesn't frighten me.
You're taught in school that everybody should have a right to their own opinion. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, suppose you lived across the way from me, and I see 10 guys coming out of your apartment, and I have a right to my own opinion. She could be a ballet instructor, language instructor. Never give people the right to their own opinion. If their own opinion is sane, and I say, what's going on there? I honestly don't know. She could be a language instructor, a ballet instructor, but if you give everybody a right to their own opinion, you think man will ever get to the moon? Nah, not in 1,000 years. I'm not interested in that. Are you a rocket expert? Do you know anything about space travel? I don't want your opinion.
And so that's why we have so much trouble with people, because they do not have a common way of seeking information. You say, well, if you ask me, I think my opinion is just as good as yours. Good. So people feel, they want to feel equal to you. They say, that's your opinion, now I'm going to give you mine. See? So they think one opinion is as good as another. And that's valid amongst people that don't know how to check things out.
It is very possible that this state is really a reaction of the body, a theory that sounds shocking, but it's as real and demonstrable as it can be. We'll talk about this a little bit later. As long as you enter in conflict with another person, you will not reach any agreement. Both will try to defend their idea and will not be paying attention to the other. Or if you notice that the other one is right, you will refuse to admit that because of the conflict state. The solution is not to get into a contradictory conversation, that is, through definition, a conversation that will not lead anywhere. A discussion is different, and when you come across such people, give them the word. I mean, if you meet a man who is faithful and believes in God, then ask him how he believes and from where he had the idea. Give him the word. Tell him that you want to believe as well, to convince you, to show you how God really exists. So maybe you will discover something new. Or maybe he will realize that he is wrong. Same with a man caught in the monetary system, money, cars, business. Ask him what is the ultimate goal, where he wants to get, and what he really wants to do. Tell him that he lives and feeds with imagination, that he owns the car because others accept that and believe him, or that his business is just transferring money, and money had just some purpose. It's difficult to reach such people, but you can try to give them the word to explain why they are so confident on their thoughts. The monetary system encourages this blind faith through illusion of voting and the right to opinion, although it's doing that into an extremely separated and different society.
You've heard all this, you as a human being. Why don't you change? What prevents you? If each one of us ask that question, not verbally or merely intellectually,
as an entertainment. But ask that question most seriously and deeply. What's your answer? What's your answer to this problem that human beings have lived this way for millennia upon millennia? Why haven't they changed? Why haven't you, who are listening now, why haven't you changed? You know, if you don't change, what the consequences are? You'll be nationalistic, you'll be tribal, insular, isolated, and therefore having no relationship globally, fighting, building up more and more armaments to destroy each other. Now, why don't you, if you are at all serious in this matter, why don't you ask yourself that question? Why am I a human being who have been through all this? Why haven't I changed? What would be your answer? Either you are not serious, you want to live a very, very superficial life, and that superficiality temporarily satisfies you, or you really don't care, as long as you have immediate pleasures, immediate satisfactions. You really don't care. You don't care for your children if they are murdered. If you really have no deep love, affection for them, if you had, you would prevent all wars. So, apparently, none of these things mean anything to you. Or probably, you are so deeply conditioned psychologically. Of course, we are biologically conditioned, that's a different matter altogether. But psychologically conditioned, and one is not aware of it. And you can, unless there is freedom from that conditioning, you will go on this way.
It's funny, but amazingly shocking, how people can be so confident in a situation where they know just a fraction about the environment, about their body, about the planet Earth, or the universe. How can you be so confident